Good Sunday evening, everyone. I'm meteorologist Taylee LaPointe. Here's a look at your updated forecast. Man, today was another scorcher, and with the humidity levels still high, it has felt uncomfortable. With the heat and the humidity factored in, these were some of the readings that it felt like this afternoon. Into the upper 80s up north, and then more like the upper 90s in Concord, Manchester. Even at times today, it felt like over 100 degrees in the southern part of the state. So hopefully you had a way to cool down, because this has been so uncomfortable, particularly with the high humidity levels. And you can see the dew points right now running in the 70s in spots, upper 60s. You see Laconia at 71. So with dew point readings like that, it just feels incredibly uncomfortable, sticky. And yes, it is in the oppressive zone. We have dew points running in the 70s. Good thing is, though, that's going to change over the next 24 hours. The humidity about to go down in a big way. And of course, the way that we do that is by getting a cold front to move through. Now, what that also means is we could have some pop-up thunderstorms that get going here, especially later on in the evening in southern areas of the state in particular. But it's not going to be like last night where we had widespread rain and thunderstorm action. It's going to be very, very isolated, meaning some of you may get them, but probably the vast majority of you don't. So you can see nothing is really materializing at this point, but that will likely change as we get into the evening hours here, and maybe even during the early part of the overnight hours too, as this cold front continues to march its way across New England and the northeastern states. You see some stronger storms back into New York State right now. Behind the cold front, of course, some much less humid air, so that'll feel much better tomorrow, and we'll actually have some quieter weather too. No more threats for storms, at least until Tuesday or Wednesday of this next week. So here's how things go, timing everything out. We have really the chance of just these pop-up thunderstorms at any time this evening, but again, they're going to be isolated. It's not everybody gets them. Otherwise, we'll have partly cloudy conditions, and by midnight tonight, that threat is gone. So you should be able to sleep well tonight. I know the thunder was rumbling late last night for a lot of you. Finally, tomorrow morning, we'll get to start to see the sunshine, though tomorrow's going to be a day where we'll have a mix of sun and clouds, and you might notice a couple little green splotches here up north, north of the notches in the mountains tomorrow. There's a chance of some scattered showers, especially early in the day, as that cooler, less humid air starts to come down out of Canada. Tomorrow evening, though, bright and sunny, just a few passing clouds. Tuesday, the forecast changes a little bit with clouds starting to roll in and some much needed wet weather starts to roll in for late in the day on Tuesday and into Wednesday too. Looks like we could have some very beneficial rainfall moving through. Overnight tonight, coolest spots up north where you're after the cold front has moved through. So temperatures a little bit cooler in Berlin at 59, but most other locations still in the 60s, even some low 70 degree readings during the overnight hours. And then here's your forecast for tomorrow. Now, despite this cold front moving through, it's still going to be a warm one. Yes, even some 90s again in Manchester, Salem, and Nashua, but the big difference will be the humidity will be much lower, so it won't feel as oppressively hot as it has recently. Here's your 7-day forecast and a look at the work week ahead. After tomorrow, we do get some unsettled weather in here with showers on Tuesday, Wednesday, and even into Thursday, but look at the temperatures. Much more bearable in the 80s, not quite as uncomfortably hot. At the end of the week, back to sunshine. Temperatures start to warm up next weekend, and so far, of course, this could change. We're still so far out, but next weekend looks really nice. Lots of sun, temperatures in the mid 80s. Have a great week.